Hello again, everyone, and welcome back to my channel for another J-pop album review. So with this being Namie Amuro's retirement month, I decided that I should honor her. So today we are going to be reviewing her last full studio album, Genic. So obviously, guys, I know this thing came out like 3 years ago and I still haven't reviewed it, so forgive me for that. But today we are going to get into this one, so let's go ahead and get started. Track one is called Photogenic, which obviously by the title of the album, Genic. This song, I think it's a good introductory track kind of for what's to come because it does set the vibe for the rest of the album. And I don't hate this song, but I'm not in love with it. It's just okay. The instrumentals and how they add the sound of like the camera click and the photography with the flashing and all that, like I think that's really crafty, it's really creative and cool, and it just adds that extra effect with the song being called Photogenic, which makes sense. And this song, it's catchy, I'll give it that. When you think cameras flashing, follow the action, they call me photogenic. But this song, this song kind of makes me laugh because it's so like, it makes her sound like a narcissist, and she's like, oh, I forget the lyric she says now. Like, she knows she's always photogenic, put my picture on the wall, everyone knows I'm beautiful. It's a little much, you're a little cocky there, but, you know, it's a good song, and it sets the vibe for it, and it's a fun song, because this song is setting the precedence for the rest of the album, and the fact that I feel like with this one, she kind of just wanted to have fun with it. It wasn't that she was trying to create a super serious album. She was just trying to have fun and enjoy herself and sing songs that are catchy. So those are my thoughts on this first track. Again, it's okay, but I'm not obsessed with it. Track two is called Time Has Come. I do actually like this song more than Photogenic because it's more unique and like the way that it displays itself to me with the instruments, it just sounds more unique and I really like that. And the different effects that they added in, and I like how Namie's voice, it's very, what's a good word for it? Her voice just flows very well. Like, I feel like her voice is floating. That doesn't make any sense. But the way that it just goes up and down in the rhythm, like, she just stays very fluid throughout the entire thing. It's just, like, at the beginning, just sounds great. This part kind of weirded me out at first, but now I do actually like the song, because I hated the song when I first heard it. But now I really like it. And when I actually saw her Genic tour, I really had more appreciation for this song as well, because when she sang it live, number one, I always typically like the songs more once I see a live performance of it, but she just looked like she was having a blast, and it's a really catchy song, and I found myself, like, just when I was cleaning or doing whatever around the house, like, I would literally be humming this. And guys, let's be honest, okay, yes, this song is predominantly in English, but her English has come a very long way. And she sounds much more fluent. And there's only a few things that I notice here and there that, you know, sound more like English, but she's done a really good job with this, so let's give her some props. Track three is Golden Touch. Oh my gosh, guys, I love this song. It's so cute. Right from the get-go, just bam, it just comes in. Oh, you got the golden touch. You got the golden touch. It's just, it's a very catchy song, but it's so, like, modern day in a sense. Like, I feel like this song would have actually done really well, like, over here on the West Coast, like, in America. Like, this could have been something that I felt would have been, like, the top 10 in America, but it wasn't. But I know that the music video went massively viral, and it was seen in North America and all this stuff, but okay, guys, I thought the music video was, like, it's cool, you know, put your finger there, all the stuff, like, I get it, but for the album's sake, I kind of wish the DVD, like, she had done a separate music video for it that featured more of her and not just these objects. When you're watching it on, like, a TV, like, I'm not about to walk up to the TV to be like, you know, like, it's just, I don't know, kind of silly, but this song is so catchy and it's so cute and it just makes me want to dance every single time. They did a fantastic job on the arrangement of all the instruments, and it's kind of like, you know, a big band sound, and I really like that. It's just different. It's definitely just throws it in the mix right there in the middle, right here at the third song of the album, and just brings that energy up. So, awesome song. Track four is Birthday, and oh my gosh, this song is so cute. I really like this one.
Got balloons flying in the sky, and my DNA's riding on cloud nine. So everybody come on and shout, it's my birthday, hey, gonna make it fly. Got my friends in the champagne glass, gonna party hard with the night skyline. Today's the anniversary of new me.
Okay, obviously her saying today's the anniversary of new me. It should be of a new me. But regardless, guys, forgive some of that and just love this song. This song is so simple, but it's adorable and cute. And come on, I know you have all seen the music video for this song. And of course, the whole thing is shot in like one take in this just in this one room. And I loved how at the Genic tour, she literally did the whole performance like the same thing, went in there, changed her outfit, and came out. It was just adorable, and Namie has the best and cutest smile in that music video, and it just makes that this song so worth it. So if you haven't seen that video, you better go watch that. But this song is fantastic and cute, and if I'm feeling depressed, I literally will go listen to this song because I can't help but smile every time I hear it, because it's just a good mood and positive and uplifting. And yes, guys, I'm that person that listens to this song on my birthday, just like Kodakumi's Birthday Eve. I know. Now I just need Hamasaki Yumi to come out with a birthday song, and then I'll have all three queens. Track five is It. And just when I thought that she couldn't get more cute songs, this song comes in. First off, you've got this whistling, which adds such an awesome element to this song.
Love is like a playground. We're playing tag now. We chase each other round, 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 round. Up, playing hide and seek.
It's so catchy, which is perfect because the idea of this song is the game of tag. Tag, you're it. And did you guys know that tag stands for touch and go? I just learned that the other day, and I kind of feel like I've been missing something my entire life. But maybe that's just me being stupid and not paying attention to it. Regardless, with the whistling and how the song has this beat, it's a catchy beat, they're catchy lyrics, and the idea of it being catchy works perfect for this song. And it's like, it sounds so happy and upbeat, but it's like a sad, bittersweet song because love keeps avoiding her and she just wants to be it. And it's like so sad, but it's so cute at the same time. So I love this song too, guys. Like, I listen to this one all the time. Like, ugh. The birthday song and this one, like, ugh. Great job, Namie. Six is Scream. And this song is kind of more on your like EDM sound, and it's a good song, but it's not my favorite. It doesn't stand out to me quite as much as the previous tracks have, because it kind of feels like something off of her Feel album. I felt like it would have fit really well there, but it's still a good song, and her vocals are very strong here, and it's still catchy.
We're singing, yeah, oh, oh.
Like, it's a good song, but like I typically don't listen to this one like on its own unless I'm like working out or dancing, because I don't know, it's hard for me to just sit and listen to this one all the way through. But it's still an okay song. I'm by no means have I encountered anything on this album that I'm just totally turned away from, that I'm like, this is a terrible song, why did she make this? No. This is still a good song and it does its job. Seven is Fashionista, and the second I heard the intro to this song, I was like, yep, I like this song. This song, you can just picture Namie bringing her diva attitude in, walking that catwalk, which you definitely see in the music video.
Me, everybody sees, I got the swagger. Check me out, I'm the girl you are. Watch as I make my move.
This song is just, it's such a good attitude, and it's definitely kind of like your girl power song. Nothing deep about this song, guys. It's literally about being fashionista. Everybody likes her for the way she looks and all this stuff, you know. It's your very basic, simple message. but it's catchy, it's fun. This song makes me want to dance every time. I loved the live performance of it. I wish she would do this one a little bit more because I do like this one. But Namie is just bringing it and working it here, so appreciate it. 8 is Fly. I love this song so much. This song starts off here with her just kind of saying this, and it kind of brings like a mysterious air to this. And she keeps going up and down in her notes throughout this song, and it really adds a beautiful element to it, in my opinion, just because we really get to see that flow, that fluidity of her vocals again.
I'm really high on the edge, and I do whatever I want. When I speak my mind, I say what I mean for all of the things I got.
But she's kind of talking about, like, she's living her own life. She can do what she wants. She's free. She can fly. Get away from everything. And I love this song because it's really an uplifting message to me, and it's a powerful song. Like, to me, it's a very motivating and just a powerful song. So sometimes when I'm down or I need some motivation, I will listen to this one because I just think it's beautiful. I love the line she says at the beginning because they are so powerful right here.
Now I'm moving forward, that's the only way I know. The wind at my back, cause that's the only way I go. Only one more second and I'll spread my wings and soar to the open sky.
This song is just a great overall song. 9 is Be Who I Want to Be, and this is featuring Hatsune Miku, I believe that's how you say her name. You guys know who I'm talking about, the green-haired, computerized girl thing. I'm not the biggest fan of this song. It's very odd. It's not, definitely not the best I've ever heard Namie do, but I think it's creative. You know, this is a big popular thing over there in Japan and even here in America, so I can understand why they would do it, and it's a very unique collaboration on her part. But it's not the best, but it's still an uplifting, positive song, but I just feel like the lyrics are so repetitive. And that, like, back on Fashionista, that's the one thing I don't like about Fashionista, is because they just repeat everything so much. Like, I wish there was a little bit more of a contrast in some of the lyrics. But this song's just alright. I really don't have much to say about it. 10 is Stranger. And as a song itself, I don't love it, but I don't hate it. I really like the music video for this song because Namie, she can just dance and she works it. And so I think that she does an awesome job with that. The music video and the live performance of the song makes me like the song more, but it's still an alright song. It's catchy, it does its job, but there's definitely other songs on this album that I prefer more than this. The instrumentals are definitely different and they do stand up. It's heavier on the EDM sound to me, but I don't know. It's decent. Track 11 is Every Woman. So now we come to another, like, girl power feminist song. And it's always interesting when I hear Namie kind of rap because I just feel like it doesn't suit her very well. But thankfully she doesn't do it like a ton and it sounds alright. And I really do like the chorus on this song because it's really catchy. And during the live performance in Genic Tour, it was just awesome to see everybody's hands just up in the air and they were just so excited. Like, it's a great, like, getting everybody pumped up for it right here. Like, I love that part. Like, it's just catchy, it's great, it's powerful, it just makes you want to be there and get there and be pumped up with everybody and have a party. So, good song. 12 is Space Invader. And honestly, I really didn't like this song the first time I heard it. It took me a few listens, but I actually quite like this song now. And I think it's very different and unique. But it was just, her voice was just overlapping so much on top of herself throughout it that I was kind of like, okay. But it's a cute song and it's catchy and the beat just kind of goes like this. I know this doesn't make sense that I'm making a motion for you guys, but the beat's very, it flows. Do you get what I'm saying? But that's how I kind of feel with this song, and it's just, it's a cute song, and it just makes me want to dance and kind of sing along. It's got a good beat. Like, I literally will sing this to myself, but I feel like this song is kind of like her just reflecting to herself about a situation, and it's just kind of funny too to be like, you're all up in my space, and just space invaders. It's a cute idea. 13 is Anything. This, I feel, is such a beautiful song. They did an incredible job with the composition of this song. It's just this beautiful acoustic sound. There's a few other instruments, but mainly it focuses on this acoustic guitar, and I love that sound. And the message of this song is absolutely stunning and gorgeous. And if you are down, like, this is one of the most uplifting songs. And I heard and read somewhere that she wrote this song for her son. So whether that's right or wrong, you know, this is just my opinion. You know, I think this song can be used for literally anyone, no matter what your situation is. And I literally actually wrote the lyrics to the chorus on my wall when I was at my old job in my cubicle, and I had it posted right there because some days it just sucked and I was just depressed and miserable, and I would look over and I would read that and I'd be like, I can do this, I can do this. But her vocals are beautiful, and it's just a very heartfelt song, and I won't lie, guys, like, the song makes me cry sometimes. Call me a pansy, whatever. This song I just find is beautiful, and just, she did a great job on this one, and this will definitely be one of my favorite songs. Track 14 is What I Did for Love, and this is the final track of this album. This features David Guetta. This song is different. It wasn't what I expected because it starts out so slow with like this piano, but then it picks up into this dance song. But I do like this song because it's a very powerful reflection, I feel. And most of us can connect to it because most of us have been in like some kind of a past relationship. And I don't mean it has to be romantic. It could be friendship, whatever it was. But a relationship in general. And when you look back on it, you know, at some point we've had someone betray us or stab us in the back. And it sucks and it really hurts. And when she's saying, I can't believe, right here.
I can't believe what I did for love. I can't believe what I did for us.
So I can't believe what I did for love. I can't believe what I did for us. And I feel like all of us have reached that point somewhere along the line where we're like, I can't believe I did all that for you. Like, I gave up so much, or I gave so much of myself to you, and, like, then to have this happen later where you're betrayed or whatever, lied to, whatever it may have been. And so, it's just something I feel all of us can relate to, and I feel like the beat goes very well with this mentality or the thought or message of this song, because it starts off slow as in, I'm going to meditate about this, and now it's going into, like, I'm going to dance about it, I'm going to get it out, and let's move on from this. So I actually really like this song. So those are my thoughts on each of the individual tracks. I will show you guys, I got the CD plus DVD version of her album. I didn't get a Blu-ray just because they're so expensive, and the most important Blu-rays that I have are live tours. That's what I spend the money for Blu-rays on. So, and plus there weren't that many music videos, so I just felt like it didn't justify me getting a Blu-ray. So most of you guys have probably already seen it before, but I'll still show it to you. So this is the very, really nice, shiny cover on it. There's the spine, and you open it up here. Still just all nice and shiny in there. Oh, look at that. My disc fell out. Oh, no. Okay. We're okay, guys. So there is the CD and the DVD inside there. And then over here in this part, they do have blind embossed over here her name. You can see that says Namie Amuro. And so you open this up, and this is what has our booklet inside. So a gorgeous photo of Namie right there. She always looks beautiful, of course. So this kind of reminds me, I mean, obviously the title of the album itself is photogenic, so it's going to have pretty good photos in it. So this looks like a Vogue type photo shoot to me, with the, like the black lace and everything and the red lipstick. So just open it up, and this pretty much just has like all your lyrics in it, so nothing too exciting there, you're not missing. And then there's another photo of her. And then more lyrics. So, and then I really like this photo with her hair down. She looks absolutely gorgeous. I mean, Namie, we all know, has gorgeous hair. I wish my hair could get that one. And just more lyrics. So, yeah, you're not missing anything else in it. So, I am a little disappointed because a lot of Namie albums seem to not have very many pictures, and I like pictures. So, I'm always a little saddened by that. There were three. I felt like she could have put more, but you know, maybe that's just me. And then in here, we had the little inserts for anything, and then for the Lifestyle 2014 tour, and just more little insert things. And then these are the Japanese lyrics for all those English songs. So I get that she put these in here probably for those that don't speak English to be able to read what it's about. But I feel like it would have been really cool if she'd included like some bonus tracks of maybe all those English songs sung in Japanese. That could have been something like really cool extra to add on there. So overall, guys, I thought Jennic was a pretty good, solid album. While yes, most people will complain and say, you know, oh, I don't really like her English albums, I like her Japanese ones better. Like, yes, songs always sound better in an artist's native language, I agree. But for this being mostly English, Namie really outdid herself, and she did an excellent job, and she got her vision across, I feel like, for this. And she just had a good time. She had fun recording these songs, had fun dancing to them. And so overall, this album is what it's supposed to be. Jennic is supposed to be about, you know, modeling and having fun and dancing. And it really brought that atmosphere to the table. But she also brought some really great songs like Anything and some really fun, cute ones like Birthday and It. So really, it was a great collection for one of her last studio albums. And I was grateful that not a single was included on this album. Like, it was literally all brand new songs, and that was really refreshing, because I always get a little irritated when an artist is like, oh, but five of my last singles are on this album and you're only getting four new songs or something like that, you know. And it just, it's so frustrating, because I'm like, well, just make some more. Like, those were singles, make something else. So anyways, guys, those are my opinions on that. So I just wanted to say thank you guys so much for watching this. Let's all congratulate Namie on her retirement and wish her the best. Also, my copy of Amuro Namie's final tour just got here in the mail today, so I'm probably going to go watch that, but I'll probably have to wait to watch it tomorrow, because I'm running out of time today. So thank you guys so much for watching. I do have a haul video that I'm going to be posting in like probably tomorrow, so keep your eye out for that. There's some surprises in there. So thanks guys again, and I will see you next time. I'm